There are an estimated 330 million companies in the world. That means there are a total of 300 million brand names in the world that are already taken. In such a scenario, it becomes hard to choose a name that is not only unique, but also easy to remember and strategic. Hi, my name is Dimitri Panici, and by the end of this video, you will know how to come up with a name for your business and make it official by getting a domain, a website, and a business email. So let's get started. What are the good attributes of a good brand name? Good brand names are simple. Well, obviously. For startups, a great brand name should be easy to remember and spell. Imagine your product goes viral, but people can't remember the name of your brand or spell it. Or worse, they search for your brand name with the wrong spelling, and some other brand pops up. That's nightmarish. Good brand names are long-term. Imagine you are a brand today that sells cookies from your kitchen. Well, there is a possibility that you may eventually diversify into cupcakes or cookie batter. In such a case, you might want to give your company a generic name that is applicable across all SKUs. Good brand names are original. Do you know of the famous Apple Corps versus Apple Computer case? The Beatles came first with the music company Apple Corps. 8 years later, Steve Jobs introduced Apple Computer, now Apple Inc., to the world. The two mega corporations have battled it out in court over the years. After the first round, Apple Inc. agreed to pay Apple Corps a cash settlement and to stay out of the music business. Now, you want to avoid something like this with your business by making sure your brand name is original. What I'm trying to say is, if your company has anything to do with either music or computers, stay away from the word Apple. Maybe try another fruit. Now, let's use ChatGPT to come up with a great brand name. You can open the interface. Let's start writing a prompt by informing AI about your business. You want to best describe what your business offers and what it does. Let's assume for this example that I have a small travel agency. Let's enter the prompt here. I run a small travel agency business in my home state of California, where I organize hiking trips for families with small children. My goal is to simplify the planning process for families and ensure they have all the necessary safety, equipment, and gear for their adventures. You can go into as much detail as you want. And in fact, the more detailed you are, the better for AI to understand your small business. Next, you want to give a general prompt to AI to generate a list of first travel names. Let me add it here. Based on the above description, can you please list some brand name suggestions? Here are 10 suggestions that ChatGPT has come up with. They're interesting, but this is not exactly what we are looking for. Let's understand how these names came about. So I've typed out, can you provide an explanation of each and how you came up with the brand names? As you can see, ChatGPT has given a brief explanation of each of the names. Some of the names are interesting, but seem too generic. I need names that are a little more unique. I personally like two-word brand names. Let me try that. So what we're going to do is say, now suggest two-word brand names like YouTube and Facebook. Let's see what it comes up with. Here are the results. This looks interesting. The next idea I want to show you for finding brand names is to use alternative spellings. This is how you can prompt ChatGPT for that. You say, suggest brand names that use alternative spellings like Fiverr and Lyft. We'll press enter, and here we go. As you can see, these results are really hard to pronounce and spell, so it may be a little difficult. And we'll bypass these results for now. The next tip for finding your brand name is to use what's called a portmanteau. So think of FedEx and Pinterest, where you are joining two separate words into one. All you need to do is type something like, now suggest portmanteau brand names like FedEx and Pinterest. Let's press enter, and here's what we've got. This is interesting. I like Hikster or even Submitify. They have a nice ring to them. Let's be more specific. Let's tell AI what exactly we like and ask it to suggest more such names. I'm liking the Hikster brand name. Can you please suggest more like this? These are some really cool names. I would like to see more. Explorify is a good name, simple, long-term, and original. Let me ask for a good tagline. I like Explorify. Can you give me 10 small tagline options? Sweet. Explorify, explore the world one step at a time is my new company name and tagline. I really like this. Now that you have finalized your brand name, let's make it official by getting a domain, a website, and a business email. First, we go to www.neospace and click on Get Started right here. You should be able to see this screen. Click on the button here. Let me type the domain that I wish to get. Let's check for Explorify. Oh, it's available. Awesome. Now click on the box here that says Get Free Domain. I'll enter all my details here, like my name, my existing email address, and a strong password. All right, now I get to choose my email address for my first mailbox. I'd like to go for dimitri@explorify.co.site and create the mailbox. I'll just skip this step. I don't need any general mailboxes either, so I'll skip this step as well. And this is the one page website which I plan to use as my lead generation form. I'll set this up later. I choose the plan that I want. I will go with the max plan. Now, I just add all my details here, and it's done. I'm now a proud owner of my shiny new email address and a domain, and that makes Explorify official. I'm ready to start and grow my small hiking business armed with my domain, my website, and my business email. You can try Neo for free using the link in the description below. Hope you enjoyed. Do not forget to like and subscribe to Neo on YouTube. Until next time.